Wayne's Word, Episode 28.
Hi, this is Carter Ulery. Welcome to Wayne's Word, a show designed with you in mind, sharing motivation, inspiration, and transformation. Now here's your host, my dad, Wayne Ulery.
Hello, friends. How are ya? Wayne Ulery here, and welcome to another episode of Wayne's Word. Glad to have you today. Well, listen, we got a neat show planned for you today. I'm going to do a few things a little differently. How about that? Switching things up just a little bit. I mean, we will still have the word of the day followed by our last reading in the top 10 distinctions between dream fulfillers and dream killers by Keith Cameron Smith. But I'm going to throw a little bit of a twist in the way today's show goes. I think you're going to like it. Listen, if you're listening via thirstythursdaycall.com, and as a matter of fact, if you go over to thirstythursdaycall.com, there's a blog tab there. Click on the blog tab, and you will see all the different episodes there. Feel free to click on them, listen to them. Of course, your comments are greatly appreciated. There's also share buttons. Share them with the world if you're motivated, inspired, or transformed during the episode. So take a stop by there. There's also an email list on the main page that you'll see at the top. Enter in your name and email, and you'll receive each and every episode as it is broadcasted right to your email to remind you to give it a listen. Also, if you're listening through ThirstyThursdayCall.com or Spreaker.com, that's right, we're on Spreaker.com as well. That's Spreaker.com. Just look for Wayne's Word and you'll find us there. But if you're listening through the web and you'd like to listen on your phone, which there is a Spreaker app, so you could use that, but you can also use the podcasting app that is on your iPhone or your Droid. If you don't have it, just visit your app store or marketplace and download it for free. Once you download it, search for Wayne's Word and you'll find us. Just go ahead and subscribe, and each and every podcast will be sent right to your podcasting app so you can listen to it whenever is convenient for you. I also want to tell you that if you'd like to get more information regarding Wayne's Word, all you have to do is send a text message to 50500, and you're going to send the word podcast, all one word, P-O-D-C-A-S-T. Send the word podcast to 50500, and you will get one text message that will give you the direct link to our podcast on the podcasting app. It will also give you a direct link to our mailing list, as well as a Twitter link. Well, I don't know about you, but I sure am ready for the word of the day.
Wayne's Word presents the word of the day. Enjoy.
Psalm 100, Chapter 4, verse 5. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations.
God, we've come to seek your face tonight. If that's your cry, just lift your hands. God, we've come to meet with you tonight. Our soul cries out to you. Our flesh cries out to you. We want to know you. We want to encounter you in a deeper way. Just lift your voice in your own words. Begin to lift up your hunger. Lift up your hunger. Lift up your voice. God, let us be known as a generation who seeks your face. Let us be known as a generation who calls after your name.
Wow. I don't know about you, but I feel like I just got rained on. Whew, I needed that. I hope you did too. I hope you were blessed by that song by Jesus Culture. Great group from the West Coast. You got to check them out. Jesus Culture. All right, why don't we get into the final distinction in the top 10 distinctions between dream fulfillers and dream killers? This is a distinction number one. Dream fulfillers know the dream giver, and dream killers know the destroyer. God is the dream giver. The dream giver said, "I have come that you may have life and have it more abundantly." Right before he said that, he said this about the destroyer. The thief comes to kill, steal, and destroy. The dream giver also called the destroyer the father of lies. How does the destroyer destroy your dream and eventually your life? Through lies. Lies about God. Lies about yourself. And lies about other people. If you don't believe in God, then ask yourself, if there is no God, why do I have a dream inside of me? Where did it come from? The only answer is that God put it there. If there is no God, then nothing has any meaning, and everyone would be living like animals. You may say, well, a lot of people do live like animals. That is true. But there are those who seek to live by faith versus being victims of fear. People do not know the dream giver will always live. People who do not know the dream giver will always live in fear and continually experience stress, doubt, and worry. Those who know the dream giver will learn to overcome fear and live by faith, which produces peace and joy. Pursuing your dream will require you to face your fears, and achieving your dream will require you to overcome them. Where does fear come from? It comes from believing lies. One of the biggest lies is that there is no God. Three big lies and three great truths. The three big lies are, there is no God, he doesn't love you, you can't fulfill your dream. Three great truths are, there is a God, he does love you, and you can fulfill your dream. Imagine the following conversation. Destroyer, there is no God. You, yes, there is. Destroyer, okay, there is a God, but he doesn't love you. I mean, how could he? You are so screwed up, and you fail all the time. You, yes, there is a God, and he loves me unconditionally. Destroyer, okay, there is a God, and he loves you, but you can't fulfill your dream. It's impossible. You, with God, all things are possible, so yes, I can fulfill my dream. Have you ever had a conversation in your heart or mind that is similar to this? To believe the destroyer means you agree with his lies. To be free of him, all you must do is believe the truth. There is a God, he loves you, and you can fulfill your dream. Your success is dependent on who you are connected to. You listen to people you are connected to. Listen to the truth of the dream giver, and you can and will fulfill your dream. Listen to the lies of the destroyer, and your life will be filled with fear, doubt, worry, and stress. Here is a clue on how to discern between the dream giver's voice and the destroyer's. The dream giver's voice speaks through your heart, and the destroyer's voice speaks to your mind. Your heart is full of faith, hope, and love. Your mind is based in fear, doubt, and anger. Your heart and mind have conflicting desires. To become a dream fulfiller, you must learn to discern between the deep desires of your heart and the deceptive desires of your mind. The deep desires of your heart are put there by the dream giver. Consider the words desire and inspire. The root meaning of the word desire is of the Father. The root meaning of the word inspire is in the Spirit. The desires that inspire you were put in your heart by the dream giver. Learn to listen and follow your heart. The deceptive desires that the destroyer puts into your mind are things that you think will make you happy and fulfilled, but they can't. Deceptive desires are first and foremost based on lies. The deep desires of your heart are based on truth. Truth creates peace. Lies create stress. When your head and heart are arguing, you will experience confusion. To get rid of confusion, listen to your heart and tell your head your fears to shut up, and then do what the dream giver is telling you to do through your heart. Your heart knows the way. Your mind is confused. Your heart is peaceful. Your mind is stressed. The reason your heart is full of faith, hope, love, and peace and knows the way is because that is where the dream giver resides. Don't you know that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit is the dream giver and lives within you. I'm not talking about religion and I'm not talking about truth. Truth transcends religion. If you are interested in my views and experiences with religion, please read my book, The Top 10 Distinctions Between Relationship and Religion. Inspiration and encouragement are a benefit of being in relationship with the dream giver. It takes continual inspiration and encouragement to keep moving toward your dream. One of the primary reasons people don't take action on their dreams is because they are waiting for someone else to give them permission to do so. Here is the truth. You don't need anyone's permission to pursue your dreams because you already have the permission of the one who gave you the dream. Get to know him. One of the prayers in scriptures is, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. Perhaps that the destroyer has killed your dream. Well, there's another truth. God can resurrect your dream. To become a dream fulfiller, you may have to go through the death and resurrection of your dream. Maybe your dream isn't dead. Maybe it is simply asleep, and all you need to do is ask the dream giver to help you wake it up. If you do, then be ready for a shaking. If you have fallen asleep because of eating too many lies, maybe God is shaking you to wake you up. He is waking you up because you have a dream to fulfill. Wake up, get up, and stay up. Persevere until you fulfill your dream, and in the end, the dream giver will give you a crown of life. If you know the dream giver, then always remember this. In the end, everything will be fine. If everything is not fine, then it is not the end. Remember, dream fulfillers know the dream giver, and dream killers know the dream destroyer. What now? Keith says, read this book often. I recommend reading it once a month until you feel the 10 distinctions have become a part of who you are. Repetition is the primary way we train our minds to think differently. When we think differently, we act differently, and we achieve different results. Share copies of this book with the important people in your life so you can discuss the distinctions and learn from one another's experiences and perspectives. Go to www.keithcameronsmith.com and register for the Wise Distinctions email to receive continued support in developing your mindset for a positive attitude and success. You can also join me for teleseminars and get information about upcoming Wisdom Creates Freedom workshops. Well, there you have it, the top 10 distinctions between dream fulfillers and dream killers. If you want to listen to all 10, just review the last 10 episodes of Wayne's Word and you'll be able to get those. I think this was a really good chapter. It was awesome and it went well with today's word of the day. I truly hope that today's message has reached you in some way, either providing some motivation, inspiration, or some transformation. That's my hope here at Wayne's Word. And I like where Keith mentioned that you have to continually inspire yourself, continually, you know, motivate yourself to get to your dream. You know, you can't just listen to an episode of Wayne's Word and call it a day. You know, that's it. It's not to say you have to listen to me every single day, but you definitely need to be inspiring yourself and motivating yourself on a daily basis to reach your dream, because your mind is going to want to get in there and throw you off track and get you away from achieving your dream. But deep down in your heart, we know you have a dream. Pursue it. Persevere. Seek it out. Your dream is here for others. Thanks for listening to Wayne's Word, episode 28. And remember, for motivation, inspiration, and transformation, you'll always find a show designed with you in mind, right here, right now, with Wayne's Word. And no, you don't need a degree for a little MIT. We'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye now.
What we do in life echoes in eternity.